Welcome back for the online class. In the previous class, we were discussing on PLC. Okay, I gave the definition of the PLC and the PLC operation steps. Okay, I'll repeat. The PLC operation involves three steps. There is the input status, execution, and output status. The very much important, the concept behind the PLC will be the response time. The how fast the response time of a application, it will indicate the process. Now, let me take a today's topic on response time of a PLC. Okay, before I discuss on this one, let me have an example. Okay, now if a person sees a picture on a wall, okay. Now, when person see a picture on a wall, the very first the organ of a human body will sense is eyes. Means the eyes will perceive the picture. Means you can correlate this will be with respect to the sensor. When the sensor, okay, when the data is perceived by the eye, it will be transmitted to the brain and it will compile. It will execute that. Oh, it is a picture. Means after this one, okay, now you can say your exclamatory sentence, this is a picture on a wall. Look at this, there is a three steps has been involved. Your eyes has perceived the image, executed by the brain, and it will be transmitted from your mouth, that's the words, okay, is a picture on the wall. Okay, means the execution time, okay, is it will be like a very important for the data to be transmitted from the application. Okay, now if your eyes cannot see the picture, okay, then we call it as a response time. Means if you are perceiving a image in a very late, okay, something like a delay is involved, then the response time will be getting more. Then you can, after looking into the picture, you say there is a picture on the wall, means the total total process will be getting delayed for the certain amount of interval. Okay, that should not happen with a process. Okay, it is not good enough for the application purpose. Similarly, if I took it for the industry, if any one operation is happening, for example, in the previous class I discussed on like a packet, there is a biscuit industry for a packaging. When the packet is poured with a biscuit, okay, when it has been drawn back near the packaging, okay, packaging of a machine, within no time it has to get sealed. If it could not able to do, then the process will not be performed in an actual way, so it will be get failed. Okay, this way, okay, the very very important factor operation behind the PLC will be a response time. Since what we have taken, okay, in the previous step, okay, is input, execution, and output. Okay, that is the input will be, it took a certain amount of time for the brain to notice the signal from the eyes. Definitely there is a delay will be exist, because all the way the image will be perceived by the eye and it will reach to the brain. Okay, how much time will be like that, the delay will be exist. Okay, once it is reached here, then your brain will start getting processing. Means it is a, we call it as a compilation time or a execution time. After this one, okay, the signal has been perceived by the brain or executed, it will be send a signal to the mouth. So it will be, there is a total time interval will be exist. Means look at this one, how I am calculating the total time interval will be input response time, that is from eye to brain. Execution time, the time taken by the brain from the brain to the mouth, it is a total output response time. Okay, that is what the, this is what the signaling operation is happened with respect to your a PLC controller also. Okay, I hope you are getting, you know this, how I hope you are understood the what the concept behind the PLC response time. Okay, now look at this one, I'll take with a diagrammatic fashion. Okay, now it will be given, okay, there are the three steps: input, input execution and output, what we call as an update. Okay. Now, initially we will take a scan 1. Okay, scan 1 in the sense it will be performing with the scan 1 operation, scan 2, scan 3 will be like 3 steps are for a one particular process. Okay, in the scan 1, okay, there are the 3 steps: input, execute and output. Okay, look at this one. The input will be here taken amount of time. Okay, there is a delay. There is a delay for the signal. Okay, let us take that it is a T1 time. I will take a T1 time interval. Okay, now you just compare with like the previous example what I given with like the picture on the wall. Okay, the how much time your eyes will take, it will take, we call it as a T1 time. Okay, now once it is perceived, it will be transmitted to the brain. Okay, we call it as a execution time. Okay, once it is transmitted to the brain, it will start executing. Okay, there is a T2 time. Okay, what is that? Execution time. Okay, once executed, it will be transmitted to your mouth that, okay, oh, there is a picture on the wall. This is the words will be coming out from your mouth. Okay, so this will be like a T3 time. Okay, now can I say the response time will be nothing but T1 plus T2 plus T3. I hope you understood this one. Okay, how small this interval will be like a faster the operation? How the longer the, how much, the more the delay will be exist for this T1, T2, T3, then the application or a process will be getting delayed. That should not be the good application for the any of the industry. Okay, what they want to do, they want to reduce this response time. Okay, similarly, okay, this will be considered that this is for the one application it is performed, and for the second one, okay, I hope in program execution and output time will be T3 time. Okay, now again in the scan 2, this process will be keep on repeating. Okay, this will be happening with respect to the clock pulses of the PLC oscillator. Okay, then the oscillator will play a very important role for the execution of a process. Okay, because all your application of a PLC will be synchronized with the oscillator. Okay, this is what the scanning we call it as a scan diagram of a PLC. okay, it will be getting repeated. Okay, I hope you can understood this one. This is a scan 1 up to this one. Again the scan 2 will be taken. Okay, what will be the time interval again? T1 time interval. This will be T2 time interval execution. This will be T3 time. It will be getting repeated. You consider this is the process P1, this is process P2. Okay, you consider this will be like a in a biscuit factory, like a pouring of a biscuits in a packet. Pouring of a biscuits in a packet. Okay, then this will be like a packaging of a the time taken for the packaging, it means it will be getting sealed. Okay, you consider this will be like a time to pour in a box, means how much time it will be take a scan 1, scan 2, scan 3. That is a, you need to decide that how much time is required for the process to be getting involved. Okay, there is a total scan 3 time, scan 3 line will be given for the biscuit industry industry for the packaging. Okay, now okay, in this diagram you can see, okay, the first diagram what I have mentioned here. Okay, this is to avoid the input should not be turned on for at least one input delay plus one scan time. Okay, as you can see in the diagram here. Okay, that is, there's a one delay interval will be given here. Okay, there is a like a processing, if the process P1, P2, P3, there is a certain amount of delay will be given, okay, between P1 to P2, P2 to P3. Okay, since, okay, in this, in the diagram, the right side diagram, what you have mentioned here, if the input was not long enough, then the PLC does not see the input turn on, which is not desirable. Hence, there are two ways to overcome this advantage. By one, with a pulse stretch, okay, that is, it will extend the length of the input signal until the PLC looks at the input during the next scan. Okay, that is what I mentioned is like insertion of a time interval. That is, it stretches the duration of the pulse. Okay, that is the other method by using interrupt function. Okay, that is let us check that. Once the P1, okay, what the processes will be like, something like process P1, the next followed with a process P2, next followed with a P3, okay. What we have given in between the P1 and P2, there is a first one, will be like we are inserted with the delays, okay. So, if there is a delay, the P2 will be it will start operating after this delay interval, okay. This will be the first operation, or else in between this, okay, what we call is interrupt, okay. Likewise, P1, P2, P3, which is of operation to be performed first? P1. Once the P1 is completed, it will send a signal. It will send a signal in the form of like on or off. Okay, let us say that it is on, means we call it as an interrupt. Means P1 is completed, it is interrupting to the P2. Now which process is operating? P2 is operating. Okay, that is the second operation. Okay, now the P2 will be in process. Okay, how long? Until this execution operation is happening. Once the P2 is completed, it has to trigger the P3. So it will be sending again in the form of like an interrupt, that will be in the form of like a 1. The previous method, what we made, in between each P1, P2, P3, we have inserted the delays. Okay, the second method, we are giving in the form of like interrupt. When P1 will complete operation, it will send a signal to the P2 in the form of like interrupt. We call it as interruption. Okay, until unless the P1 will be completed, the P2 will not be turned on. Okay, now when the P2 is completed, it will turn on the P3. Means when the P2 is in execution, P3 will not be turned on. Okay, this is what the operation will be happening. Okay, with respect to the interrupt concept. Okay. Now I hope the diagram will be clear for you. Okay. Anyway, I'll share the detailed diagram. Okay, it is a diagram what we have shown. It is in the form of like a scanning 1, scan 2, okay, operation. I hope it is clearly visible for you. Okay. Now let us move to the next topic. We call it as a relay. Okay, as I told, the relay plays a very important role for your PLC, programmable logical controller, because they are all operated depends on like a response time. How fast the response time, the better the application, better the industrial application, or better will be the process. Okay. The main purpose of a PLC to replace the real world relays. Okay, that is, a relay is basically an electromagnetic switch. Okay, someone given the answer yesterday. Okay, it is an electromagnetic switch. When a voltage is applied to the coil, a magnetic field is generated. This magnetic field attracts the contacts of the relay in causing them to make a connection. These contacts act like a switch and allow current to flow between two points, thereby closing the circuit. Okay, I hope you understood the words. Okay, let me explain about this one. Okay, now with a simple circuit diagram. Okay, let us consider a turning on of a bell. Okay, you consider it is a bell. The bell will be getting on or off. Okay, now in this below circuit, you can see there is a switch. Okay, there is a switch. We have a DC voltage. Okay, now when the switch is open, okay, there is no current, because the circuit is not closed. Okay, when there is no current, okay, when there is no current in the coil or in the circuit, then the coil will not be magnetized. Means it will be no contacts. Means no contact means it is electromagnetically coupled. Means there is no coupling between the coil and the contact. Hence the bell will be off. I hope you understood this one. Okay. Now assume that you have closed the switch. When the switch is closed, now the DC, due to the DC, the current will flow in the circuit, because the circuit is closed. When the circuit is closed, your coil will be magnetized. When it is magnetized, it will be coupled to the contact. how the contact will be? It is an electromagnetic contact. Okay, because when it is energized, then the contact will comes into existence. When this will be comes into existence, means the circuit is closed. So what will happen? The bell will be ringed. Means the circuit is closed here. You can see the bell will be buzz. Okay, now this is how, okay, it will be operating. Okay, the switch will be on or off depends on like a switch. Sorry, the contact will be on or off depends on like a switch. Okay, what the in what process this will be coupled? The electromagnetic, means the magnetic coupling. Okay, that is when the switch closes, the current is applied to a bell and it is causing it to sound. Okay, since what we have given in the, what we have shown in the figure, it seen that it consists of two separate circuits. One circuit is a DC part and the other one is a AC part. In this causes, okay, a DC relay to control an AC circuit. Okay, look at this one. Your DC, okay, the DC will be, when the DC will be comes or energized with the circuit here, when the switch is closed. When the switch is closed, coupled, then AC will be comes into picture. That is what we call using DC relay to control an AC circuit. Okay, when the switch is open, no current flows through the coil of the relay. As soon as the switch is closed, the current starts to flow through the coil and causing magnetic field to build up. Okay, and the bell will sound. Okay. Hence, AC flows through the bell, and the sound of the bell you can hear it. Okay, because your bell will be operated on the AC, not on the DC, but the coil will be getting energized depends on the DC. Okay. Okay. Now this will be on the way. What we have shown in the diagram, okay, it will be replaced with the relay with the PLC. Okay, the post process is necessary to create what we call is a ladder diagram. Okay, we call it as a ladder diagram. Okay, we'll discuss in detail about this. Okay, what you mean by ladder diagram? Okay, a ladder diagram is nothing but it consists of vertical lines called bus bars, and within these vertical lines are placed various horizontal lines consisting of input contacts and output. These horizontal lines are called as rungs. We have to create a ladder diagram, means there is a contacts. Okay, there is a contacts. Okay, what is the contact here in the relay? From DC to AC. Okay, we make a contacts from processes for P1 to P2. In the previously what we took here, process P1, process P2 and P3, there has to be getting on. Once when P1 is completed, P2 has to be on. P2 is completed, P3 has to be on. Look at this, how the systematically it will be getting turning on and off. Okay, this will be flowing in the form of like a ladder. Okay, fortunately most of the like a PLCs have a software which convert this ladder diagram into a code. Means all the way they are going to be getting operated depends on like a code. Okay, when they are operating in the, okay, when they are operating in the form of like a code, okay, we need to be considered with the steps of operations. Okay, now look at this one. Okay, there is a diagram will be shown. Okay, for the ladder, this will be diagram, what we call is a relay symbol. Okay, this one and this one, relay symbols is used, okay, for the purpose. And one more, there is a coming line. Okay, I hope you can see, we call it as a ladder diagram. Okay, this is called the basic ladder diagram, in which the symbols, okay, what we are relays, the two relay symbols are given out in this way, the relays, okay, and it is an end. These are all on a controlled with the software codes. Okay, now let us see how this will be operated here. Okay, this ladder will be operated in the form of like a steps. Okay, now the first step, we have to translate all the items we are using into symbols. Okay, there is a PLC understand. Okay, it will be given, it is replaced in the form of like a symbols. Okay, look at this, you can use any symbol because all the way they are the digitally controlled, 000 0600, like this will be getting on or off. Okay, the PLC does not understand the terms like a switch, relay, bell or something like this. It will be all the way, it will be understood depends on like a digital codes what we are transmitted. Okay, since the batteries or power supply is replaced by a symbol. Okay, this symbol is common to all the ladder diagrams. Okay, what we call is a ladder diagram. You consider this will be like a relay and it will be connected with a battery. Okay, this I hope I told in the previously, vertical bar, this is a vertical bar and a horizontal bar. Okay, this is what runs what we have connected here for the ladder diagram. These look like two vertical lines on either side and the input and the outputs are replaced with these bars. Okay, that is the left side can be considered as a voltage and the right side ground. Okay, this will be left side will be considered as a voltage and the right side will be considered as a ground. Okay, and the current will be flow from left to right. All the way it will be go to from left to right. Inputs and outputs each are also given a symbols. Okay, what we call this will be like a input symbol and a output symbol from the ladder. Okay, and these symbols are visible for you. As you can see, only one output is normally used, that is a bell. Okay, for a purpose of understanding, I took a example of a bell. Okay, in which the output will be, it is a bell, it will be getting ringing on and off. Okay, this is what the symbol to be used. Okay, and it is replaced with a ladder diagram. Okay, and it is considered as a switch, relay switch, or we call it as a relay. Okay, now just a general question that, okay, what will be the like a input is a DC, what will be the controlled signal, it will be AC. okay, since AC supply is an external supply, hence it is not put in ladder diagram because we are not showing it here, because it is all the way it is controlled with the AC. Okay, from the diagram, okay, the step will be to convert the schematic into logical sequence of events. Okay, this will be all the way it will be converted in the form of like a logical sequence. Okay, if I can use this one with a replace with like a one more here. Okay, again one more, what we call is end. Okay, because you consider this is a process P1, process P2, and there is a connection. Okay, now all the way I took, this is a line, it's a common line in between this, it's a connection. I just shown for you to understand, we given with the arrow, but this line will be connected with the one more. Okay, like this, I'll replace with this one. Like this. Okay, this is a process P1 controlled relay, P2 controlled relay, P3 controlled relay. Okay, this is what a step of operation. Okay, that is what the PLC, what to do when the circuit events are taken place. Okay, the PLC should be told what are the operation to be operated, because the P1 will be in the previous, it will be like input, P2 will be execution, P3 will be output updates. Okay, because the each particular relay has been told, it is not told like a human beings, it will be all the way it is controlled by the software. Okay, this is what the how the ladder operation, in fact it is a ladder of a relays. Okay, operates for your PLC functioning. Okay. I hope you understood. Okay. Like one more here, a factor I given for you is a code. Okay, the input is called as a zero. There is a code. Okay, it is a 00. You may have a question that why it is mentioned as 000, 0500. Okay, 000, you may consider as the input, and 0500 will be considered as output. It will be depends on like the coder, as a software developer. Okay, for the how, what are the codes to be given for the relay, so that it will be getting turned on or off. Okay. It is not a fix. It's not a constant or something like that. It will be changes. Or changes depends on like a operations you are performing here. Okay. I hope you understood from the today's class. I'll conclude. Thank you.